No cut is too much. The top of the frame is cut away and put aside. It's the only part of the car they're saving.
All the bolt holes and everything are all still there. We'll bolt everything right back on the car. So I'm excited about this. This looks like it's going to work out pretty good.
What seemed a little lame on design paper looks positively unmonsterish in the flesh. They roll the stripped and beheaded DeLorean out of the garage. Is that any way to treat an icon? The team walks out on day two thinking they've done a good day's work in the Monster Garage. Let's see how they think tomorrow. There were two 24-karat gold-plated DeLoreans made. Together, they're worth over $350,000, enough to buy over 56 pounds of gold.
And do you really think that's a DeLorean? That's a hovering DeLorean? Honestly.
With our input materials.
I mean, honestly, yes or no? It's not a, like, I mean, you really think that's a DeLorean that's hovering?
Well, I don't know.
I think you guys went for the ultimate easy way by cutting the whole roof line off the car.
Easy!
You can think what you want, but this is... You know, the whole premise of the show is to take one thing and make something else out of it. Not take something that already is a hovercraft and decorate it to look like a DeLorean. That's stupid. Like the swamp boat, we should have took the Volkswagen and then just drove it right onto like a Bayliner. And then that would have been a swamp Volkswagen swamp boat, right?
You know, I'm game. I'm good with just packing it in and saying, all right, it's a failure. Let's save ourselves
the
3 days.
No, I'm not saying it's a failure. I'm trying to figure out a way to make it cool. If you don't have the desire to do it, don't do it.
No,
I ain't forcing anybody to be here.
If
you don't have the desire, if you want to pick something totally easy and lame to do, go do that.
I would.
You know, just do it on your own.
If I didn't want to do it, I wouldn't do it.
This show's a challenge. And, you know, if it's not a challenge, then we're not going to do it. Wow, this is a toughie.
Well,
you guys f***ed this one up good. It's gonna take a miracle to like pull a rabbit out of a hat on this one.
We could grab another underbody.
I mean,
another underbody.
Let's do that. Let's make Jesse happy. Let's get another underbody.
Hey, I'm trying to make you guys look good and not look like.
Oh, you know? Thank you. Likewise.
You know, this ain't my first picnic. So if you think you're being,
body.
You know.
Now
cool on TV, keep doing it, you know?
The bottom line is Jesse thinks this project sucks as is, so why don't we defer to his wishes?
I think I should have stayed here and babysit you guys all night so you would have did it the right way.
Oh, I mean, let's be realistic. We can salvage this skirt and that stuff, attach it to another car, get that car as light as we can.
Yeah, I don't have a problem cutting this apart and using the parts off it, but actually using the thing intact. I mean, if you don't see that that's lame, you know, you don't see it, or you think that's totally cool?
Hey, I thought it was cool until you told me it wasn't.
If we do it the way we're doing it, it can be a cool thing, but like he says, what's really that difficult? Just chopping off the top of the car and setting a hovercraft and make it work.
No, you guys are missing the whole point of the show. You and you obviously want to be on TV really bad. No about it, you know?
Well, that's really not the case.
No, you do, both of you. I've seen both of you, the way you act, you know, you're hamming it up for the camera and like that. You know, the show's about fabrication and stuff like that. You think it's funny?
Nope. You are the boss. What you say goes.
Go.
You wish for me to leave?
Yeah.
I'm not laughing at you, and you're building the stupidest thing I've ever seen, and I'm not laughing. You see me laughing?
Well, you know, you told me to go. I should go.
Bye.
Thank you. It's been a pleasure meeting your set and your crew.
Yeah, you said enough. Just beat it.
See you, Rich.
All right.
Don. John.
Hello.
No.
Bye.
Yeah, you said enough. Just beat it.
Bye.
You said enough.
These are the strong zip ties. These are like the kind they use for handcuffs.
My finger, bro.
We're cutting its sack off. You look like an Ewok.
The DeLorean underbody arrives, and victim number two succumbs to the Monster Garage tear apart.
Okay, we start over again.
Amidst the fury of flying parts, Don finds redemption.
It's going to be one of the projects I finish, I hope.
The team starts out low. They need to seal the underside of their monster. A patchwork of sheet metal will plug the holes and create an airtight chamber under the car.
I used to install windows, man. Kitchen
but
sink.
People couldn't see out of them. But they couldn't see out of them when you were done.
The team has a gutted DeLorean and a chopped-up hovercraft. Progress was made. The bottom was patched up. The new engine was prepped and the fan cut to fit. But with just 2 days left, they have a crushing amount of work left to do. That's it for day four. Day five starts off with something you just don't see every day. The Monster Garage DeLorean drill team. They deserve a lot of credit for willing to be seen as dorks on national television.
I know there's going to be some hovercraft people watching this and they go, man, this guy don't know what he's doing.
Too close.
Day five was a monster success. They installed the engine and fan, piped the perimeter of the car, and didn't lose anyone along the way.
This is wild, you know?
Respecting the car's Irish roots, Jesse puts the seat on the English side. 3:36, the engine is ready for its first firing.
Clear!
As day turns to night, the team works desperately to bring the DeLorean to life. There's no need for words. They're written on the exhausted builder's faces.
The odds stacked against us.
Why did it look so good the first time? I like to put it on a rack and look underneath.
It was probably sealed up, and then once it got a little pressure, it probably blew out all the little small holes everywhere.
Sure.
But it hasn't even blown off that duct tape.
I know, but there's, you know, all the little tiny leaks add up to one big one, so.
Failure.
One guy down.
We have a deadline and we missed it.
It's your call.
Jesse has no words either.
I'd rather fail at trying to do something really, really hard than accomplish something that was super easy.
All right. Job, Rich.
Thanks a lot.
You guys
appreciate all the effort.
Job done. Casey. Job.
Hey,
Joe. Test, man.
Hey, we've tried. It was fun.
Nobody likes to lose.
Hello again, Monster Troops. Sergeant Schwag reporting for duty. I want you all to stand and salute, because on the back of that trailer is a fallen monster. Private Whiteside, fill us in.
Here's what we know so far. We're down at Camp Pendleton, a military base just north of San Diego. The Marines and the Navy are teaming up on a joint mission to help dispose of this heroic but doomed monster.
Failure number three for Captain Jesse James.
They tried to turn a DeLorean into a hovercraft, but came up short.
But these dudes didn't. Say hello to LCAC, Landing Craft Air Cushion. It's 87 feet long with 460 6,000 horsepower engines. It runs on jet fuel and can do 50 knots plus. This sucker kicks serious global ass.
You think you guys could have hammered this out in a week?
Probably.
5 days, you can do it in two.
They're thinking about it too much. You need to get in there and do it.
I'll give them an A for effort.
They had the right idea.
These dudes honor all fallen soldiers. The dead DeLorean gets the Swift Intruders stamp of approval. Oorah!
Swag, looks like D-Day is getting underway.
They got a name for this operation?
Battery sucks! Oorah!
They beach the DeLorean.
And there's Jesse, here to pay his final respects.
Final thoughts for the failure?
Nope.
Jesse James, a man of few last words.
He's heading for the LCAC.
Oh, yeah, it's full battle gear for the Master Fabricator.
Looks like Jesse's riding shotgun. Jesse gives the order, the AAV responds.
Break it, Jesse. Break it. Now, break it, Jesse.
You gotta be kidding me!
It's got some food stuck in its teeth.
Complete annihilation!
Total destruction!
The DeLorean shredded! Mission complete!
Operation Failure sucks! A success!
Yeah, baby!
He's got a better idea, Swag.
You guys want some of this stuff? Yeah?
That's right! Pack it in, pack it out! We leave no one behind!
This will be mounted up somewhere. There's evidence of Jesse James being here and destroying what could have been a good hovercraft.
We appreciate you coming out.
No problem. I appreciate